Hello all, this is Damini, co-founder of WeMakeScholars, and I welcome you to the 37th episode of our web series Loanflix, Abroad Education Loan Simplified. So, as you might have noticed that over the last few episodes, we were talking about education loans with respect to the different degree types. So, in the 32nd episode, we spoke about education loan for bachelor's abroad, and then in the 33rd episode, it was education loan for pathway or foundation programs, followed by education loan for MBA abroad in 34th episode, and then education loan for executive programs in 35th episode. After that, we discussed a very uniquely challenging program in terms of funds or the education loan. That was education loan for aviation or CPL program. So now, today we are on the easiest one, that is education loan for masters abroad. So in this video, I'll be talking about what are the options which you have in terms of secured or unsecured education loans and the lenders who offer such loans for Indian students for masters abroad. I'll also briefly talk about the application process and the loan process timeline and the repayment schedule. So let's start. See, when we talk about abroad education loans, we generally discuss collateral and non-collateral loans, that is secured or unsecured education loans. So the difference between the two is that in case of secured loans, you actually need to mortgage a collateral security, that is either an immovable property like house, flat, land, or a liquid security like FD, insurance policies or government bonds. But in case of unsecured loans, you don't need to mortgage any such collateral. Unsecured loans of more than 7.5 lakhs are only given by private banks or NBFCs. So let us talk about each of these options in detail. There are three categories of lenders which can give an Indian student an unsecured education loan for masters abroad. Number one is private banks in India. Number two is NBFCs in India. Number three is foreign NBFCs. So I'm just talking category wise because there are so many names under each of these heads. So if you want to know which option is the right one for you, you can request a callback using the link given in the video description. And a financial officer from WeMakeScholars team will get in touch with you. He or she will guide you on the option and will also support you in the entire process until sanction, disbursement and beyond. Now let's talk about each of these lender options. So private banks in India can offer you up to 40 lakhs unsecured if you're going to a top university, that is your university is in top 100 or top 200 as per their list 1. If your university is not in any of these lists, then they also have a list of second best universities for which you can get up to 20 to 25 lakhs unsecured. If your university is not even in the first list or in the second list, in that case, you will not be able to get an unsecured loan from a private bank in India. The next option is NBFCs in India. They can offer you up to 45 to 50 lakhs unsecured for US, and they can give you up to 25 to 35 lakhs for Canada and up to 20 lakhs unsecured for Germany, France or Ireland. For top universities of any country, you can get up to 40 lakhs if you apply via WeMakeScholars, because a special approval has to be taken for such an amount. The rate of interest for both private banks and NBFCs in India is going to be between 11% to 14%. For more precise clarity on the rate of interest, you can watch our country specific series, that is from 17th episode to the 25th episode of Loanflix. Now the last option is foreign NBFCs. This is not applicable in all countries and it is not a recommended option because of the commercials involved. For more clarity on the foreign NBFC options and the rate of interest and other terms, you can watch episode 10th of the Loanflix series. When it comes to secured loans from government banks, the terms, policies and the commercials involved, like processing fee and loan insurance, are definitely way more favorable to an applicant. But there are two reasons that stops many from choosing this option. Number one is the need of a collateral, which I definitely understand can be a concern for many. But believe me, if you are able to arrange a collateral, there is no better option than a government bank. Number two is the delay in the processing. This is something which we can definitely take care of. WeMakeScholars is an organization which is funded and supported by the Ministry of IT, Government of India. And our sole purpose is to help students in arranging funds for their abroad studies. 75% of the loans processed at WeMakeScholars are with government banks. Hence, we definitely know how to reduce the process timeline and also how to handle the day-to-day issues at these government banks. So if you're looking help with government banks, you can definitely request a callback using the link given in the video description. And WeMakeScholars team will get in touch with you and help you further. The key terms which differentiate a secured loan is, number one, the amount. You can get up to 2.5 crore, of course with sufficient collateral, which is more than enough for any master's degree. Number two is the rate of interest is way lower than the unsecured loan options. It is about 9 to 10%. The general ticket size in a master's abroad loan is about 20 to 40 lakhs. Hence, the interest amount which you pay to an unsecured loan provider is probably about 4 to 5 lakhs higher than what you pay to a government bank in your entire loan tenure. Number three is the repayment holiday period of course duration plus 6 months to 1 year. During this period, you need not make any payments to the bank in case of secured loans from government banks. Then there are other things like lower processing fee, lower loan insurance charges, etc. All in all, the above comparison concludes that government banks are a better option provided you have a collateral security. If you are not able to arrange one, then of course we can go for unsecured options. Whatever may be the choice, WeMakeScholars team can definitely help you in the entire process. And especially for unsecured loans, you even get automatic reduction of 0.5% when you apply via WeMakeScholars. You can request a call back to WeMakeScholars team using the link given in the video description, and I'm highlighting again, all the services of WeMakeScholars are completely free of cost. See, generally the entire process, even in government banks, would not take more than 18 to 20 working days if everything is in place. But any deviation from normal profile will add on the days. Hence, you should definitely keep that buffer and leave at least 1.5 months for the entire process. If you're taking loan from a government bank, you get something called as moratorium period. That is your course duration plus 6 months. So your repayment doesn't start in this period. But if you have taken loan from a private bank or NBFC, again your EMI will start 6 months to 1 year after the course is over. But listen to this carefully. In case of unsecured loans from private banks and NBFCs, you need to pay at least the full or partial simple interest during the study period as well. But in case of government banks, you need not pay anything during the study period. Now, this whole series Loanflix is all on how to go about your education loan. So if you want to know each and everything about the loan process, you should actually watch all the episodes. But just to summarize, if you want to apply for an abroad education loan, you can actually reach out to WeMakeScholars team for the support in the entire loan process. So if you're applying for an unsecured loan to a private bank or NBFC, the process via WeMakeScholars will be mostly online. But for government banks, because the property papers and all are involved, WeMakeScholars will be coordinating the entire process from a branch nearest to you, whether it is SBI or Bank of Baroda or PNB or whichever bank you want to apply for. That's it, guys. I hope you got a clear picture of the options for education loan for masters abroad. If you have any questions, comments, feedback, doubts, anything, please mention it in the comments below and I'll definitely check it and revert. If you appreciate the effort we put in to bring this information out to you, then please subscribe to our channel. Kindly like and share it with your friends and colleagues who might be opting for a master's abroad, because you never know, lack of funds might be stopping their dream. Stay tuned for my next episode, which is going to cover all the key details for getting an education loan for PhD or postdoctorate abroad. So bye-bye for now.
Don't forget to subscribe and click on the bell icon to never miss any updates from us.